If you've read Dave Pilkey's bio, you may know that he's a perfect example of the fact that you never know which kid in your classroom might grow up to be an author. His Captain Underpants books have helped millions of children learn to read. But back when he was a kid in elementary school in Ohio, his teacher certainly didn't appreciate his talents or his sense of humor. She banished him to a desk in the hallway, and there he honed his talents. Although the teacher told him he'd better stop goofing off because he couldn't spend the rest of his days making silly books. But guess what? Besides the best-selling Captain Underpants series, Dave has also written the Ricky Ricotta books, The Dumb Bunnies, The Adventures of Super Diaper Baby, Dog Breath, The Halloweener, and The Paperboy, which was a Carver Carana book. So bad. His long-awaited new Captain Underpants book is coming from Scholastic this August. Yay! And now, belt on your boxers and button up your boogers and join me in welcoming the king of all things spring-shrunk and cottony, the amazing, one and only Dave Pilkey.
Thanks, Ben. I don't know if I should apologize for the speech I'm about to do before I did it or after. I'm probably going to do both. When I was asked to do this speech, I'll be great. And when I was told it was going to be about our most cherished and fond memories of our favorite teacher, I didn't do really very well in school, and I didn't really like my teachers. This is not going to be a good speech. Because I'm speaking to a whole group of teachers about how much I hated about my teachers. And how much they hated me even more. This is not good. Anyways, I do have a couple of my first teachers, so I wasn't much for my didn't have all that stuff, but I didn't think it would be a good idea to get up and talk about the teacher I hated the least. So I thought, probably what I would do is tell you a couple of like defining moments of my school. In second grade, I had some oral behavior problems. Nowadays, they call it ADHD. Back then, I didn't have a grade issue, but I was definitely ADHD. Worth an extra So, it was kind of rough being a second grader. My teacher moved a desk out in the hallway for me because of my inappropriate behavior in school and in the classroom. And so she would. Like every single day, I would be doing something confusing, you know, without teacher. You know this one, right? That was one of my favorites. My teacher would say to me, Mr. Pilkey, out. And I would go out into the hallway, and I had this desk up. The desk was like one of the two things I put it on. And I kept it filled up with pencils and pencils. It was kind of cool because I knew every day I was going to sit out in the hallway for a few hours. And I had a lot of time at home, so I began to draw pictures and out the hallway. And after a while, I began to write stories too. And I made these stories in the comic books. And I would bring these back into the classroom just to visit my friends, and the teacher did a lot of much. And I remember one time she took one of my towels to get something, and she took me outside, and she said to me, well, down the slope, Yes, thanks, John. She said, Mr. Pilkey, you better grow up because you can't spend the rest of your life in the sorry books. And luckily, I wasn't very good at this. And that was one of the defining moments of my childhood. Really, I'm in the middle of high school. I had a principal who was horrible. And it was kind of a similar situation. I was in class and he took me outside in the hall and he said, Dylan, I know you think you're special because you can draw, but I don't want to tell you that artists are dying to get something more. And you will never make a living as an artist. The thing is that every single day was kind of like that for me. But those are the 2 days that I really remember those words. And a lot of people, when I say that, they're kind of like, they're just in shock. People sometimes like that to me, and oh, wow, probably. But actually, it wasn't horrible. And I think that was the same thing. No one had to know. I'm sure you need to break into that. And the reason I'm grateful for those things is because I'm not good at teaching. My parents knew I had a hard time skating. They knew I was always getting in trouble. And they knew that because of my behavior, they deserved that. All the trouble I was getting into is that. So, but they wanted to keep a good home for me. They wanted my home to be home. So they wanted to get a good home for me. So when I would come home from skating, I would get a good home for me. So they would miss that. I was usually really angry. Sometimes I was in school or something really different. And I'll tell you, this is so-and-so said this, that guy said that. It wasn't my fault. It's never my fault. My mom said this thing tonight. I see this in very close. And when I was young, she just said, she said something that was really good for the great colleges. So she said to me, all the time, she was like, you know, there's a reason for me. Maybe it's something cool for people to do. And that's like the last thing you want to hear. You know, all this time you've got a really bad day. It's like, you know, something exactly what it's like. But I was thinking about this case, and I was thinking back on my childhood. I was thinking, you know, she's bad. That'd be something really wrong. It's going to be close comics. It's going to be just close comics. I did the very first case on the case. Comics is something really. And, you know, my teacher looked him up as fast as I made him, but that's where that came. And also in high school, that quarterly principal I told you about, he was the inspiration from both of us. He was the inspiration from Mr. Clark. He was one of the main villains in the story, this horrible black other principal. And the two heroes of the story, George and Hale, are very much like the two kids. And just coming here and understand how this is constant inside me, and that's me, teaching these things. And so many people see me from the heart my books that I have had to do with the kids, some of the bigger changes that have passed me. And so, I guess, you know, even though my mom didn't have a teaching role, we're all teachers. All of us. They just have a different way. And so, I just want to say, thanks to you. Thanks to you. And I was like,